Institute they made, but 2003 they made in India at Bay of Bengal and they failed. So innumerable sources like these sources are going to come in. Intuitively, we want to say something because we must understand sociology, economy, political history, various other responses. Merely studying energy will not come into any conclusion. So the concluding session, I'm going to give you three major points. Number one, the global outlook. The global outlook of the energy system now is, what is the gas reserve and what is the access to oil reserves that exist now? What is the usage that we are going to do, as well as the emission level that we have to match? And then how to create alternative policies for energy productivity, as well as domestic usages, as well as for transports. Domestic usages, there are two villages in Italy as well as in Austria. They have their own power by photovoltaic cells, and also by means of their own power generation, hydroelectric power, they are self-supplied with energy. So we must induce, government must induce plans like produce your own energy, and any village, institution and individual or NGO promoting energy, they must be awarded like Nobel. So unless energy independence is given to people to produce their own energy, their enthusiasm is kindled by means of mini powerhouses they have to make, and mini sensors. If a person is not there inside the auditorium, automatically all of the power system should shut up. Shut down, not automatically it must happen. That is power sensor, mini power transformer, mini generator we have to utilize for conserving more energy, preserving and reserving more energy. That is known as real energy management. Now I am going to tell the very important point, which is known as meta-energetics. That is the energy of energy. Apart from the energy, we are having three more energy: our physical energy, mental energy and intellectual energy. If the intellectual energy does not consider about the mind energy, that is the mind which is using for destructive purposes, the mind that is selfish, the mind that is very maliciously robustic, all of these mental situation, the global and social existing and emerging mental setup must be considered by intellectuals, as well as now in the pretext of energy, transportation and other facilities, domestic facilities, nobody works at all. So inability for digestion, inability for accumulation of food and energy forces, everybody is suffering from a lot of diseases. So meta-energetics deals with application of intellectuals towards energy, in which they consider about the basic energy. So the associative energy for this energy is body. The energy that is using this energy is the mind. The energy that has dedicated this energy or detected the energy is intellect. They also should be considered. That is known as energy decency. I hope and wish that should come in India. So generally there are three things what you say techno status. One is pride, second is partnership, third is produce share. If somebody produces, we can share it. That is different. Somebody does it, we can join with them. That is partnership. But I want, apart from partnership and produce share, that India should have the pride of designing such an energy that it is really inexhaustible from the sources of gravitational tapping, number one. The second, I told, wind energy that is inexhaustibly available, nobody can exhaust it. Third, by means of the photovoltaic systems. And fourth, by means of the nano energy systems. So India should get the pride. It should enhance the study between the students. It should also encourage research scholars. And also it should teach the administrative people as well as the civilians how to use energy, how to augment and store energy and distribute it safely and prosperously. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.
Thank you, sir. I'm Ash Kumar from NGO working in the Renewable Energy Development Activities. And thank you for the history of giving a nice exposition on energy system in India. India is a leading agricultural dominant country. 80%, 60-70% live in rural area, and 80% proper not access to energy system. What should be the energy scenario required for a development of common equity, environment, energy, and economic development as a social development? What should be a strategic plan for India?
Is more descriptive than my answer. There are two things. Number one, a customized system of operation. Second thing, well equipping a nation as per the global scenario. So if we want to participate in the leading nations of power, certainly we have to enrich our status as per the global scenario by more nuclear power, by nanotechnology, by various other emerging and various other contemplated technologies. But still, we have to customize things as per our status. One is the heritage of our land. Second is the natural resources that are available in our land. Third thing is the natural economy of our land. Fourth is the mental setup of our land. Without understanding the mind setup, that is the collective consciousness of any land, you cannot impart, you cannot just generalize any system here. No doubt, agriculture He is the basic vibrant medulla oblongata of our nation. Whole world that is there. That's what I am going to say. In biofuels, if you are going to produce only elephant grass and saplings and soya oil is to be diverted for all of these things, then what you will consume? You cannot consume diesel or something else. So we have to increase the productivity. First of all, man. Second, that is machine. Man, mind and machine. Man must be energized, mind must be made pure and sharp, and machines must be energized. If these three things, ethics, efficiency and environment, if these three things are not equally, equipotentially, not evenly, equally and equipotentially, if they are not charged, that is going to be a hazard to a nation.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you for the